Anarchist politics, while resolutely frustrating the vicious aggressive moves of the U.S. imperialists against the DPRK. A joint appeal was adopted at the conference. The joint appeal said the Communist parties, Workers' parties, and Progressive humanity of the world will significantly greet the centenary of birth of the great leader President Kim Il-sung in April 2012. It also said the great Kim Il-sung had performed a model piece for the international history of politics of the 20th century and human cause of independence, and ardently called upon the political parties and organizations in all countries to grandly commemorate his centenary birth anniversary as a great political festival common to humanity. The conference also adopted a resolution supporting the Workers' Party of Korea and the Korean people in their efforts to build a prosperous socialist nation. Seminars on the exploits of Kim Jong-il and Kim Jong-un were recently held at the Mexican Institute of the Fourth Idea and the Khmer Democratic Party of Cambodia, and the seminar on the Chuchi Idea at the Chuchi Idea Study Group of the teachers of the Department of Psychology of the Chambogo University of Uganda, on the occasion of the 20th anniversary of the great leader Kim Jong-il's appointment as Supreme Commander of the Korean People's Army, and the 94th birth anniversary of the anti-Japanese war heroine Kim Jong-sip. The speakers spoke highly of leader Kim Jong-il, who has strengthened and developed the Korean People's Army into an invincible army and defender of the socialist cause with his outstanding Sungun-based revolutionary leadership. They praised that Kim Jong-sip devoted all her life to ensuring security of the great leader President Kim Il-sung and steadily implementing his enduring law. Caribbean and Bangladesh organizations issued bulletins on the 9th on the occasion of the 20th anniversary of the great leader Kim Jong-un's appointment as Supreme Commander of the Korean People's Army and the 94th birth anniversary of the anti-Japanese war heroine Kim Jong-sup. The Caribbean group for the study of Kim Il-sung's Caribbean's bulletin, an article illustrated with the photographs of the three commanders of Mount Paektu, the great leaders Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il, and Kim Jong-sup. The article said, respect for Kim Jong-il adopted the original Sungun or army first politics based on the Chuchi idea, and thus is defending the sovereignty of the country and rightly leading the course of national reunification and the course of global independence. It gave a detailed account of the immortal revolutionary life and exploits of the woman commander of Mount Paektu, Kim Jong-sup. The Bangladesh Institute of the Chuchi Idea carried an article in its bulletin, "The Desire of Kim Jong-sip." The great leaders Kim Il-sung and Kim Jong-il placed in the road of the struggle of the progressivists for independence have been widely studied and disseminated in more than 50 countries and regions this year. Many of their works were published and introduced, including President Kim Il-sung's work for the socialism and Let Us Uphold Independence, and Kim Jong-un's work, The Sungun Revolutionary Line is the great revolutionary line of our time and every victorious banner of our revolution, and the DPRK is the Chuchi-oriented socialist state with invincible might. The Chinese Global Times, the Rasmus Editors, and media of other countries reported full text or gist of their famous work. The Communist Party of Brazil, the Ethiopian Youth Committee for the Study of the Chuchi Idea, the Pro-Korea Institute of Culture and Friendship, and the political parties and organizations and regional organizations posted their works in their bulletins or internet homepages. A total of over 70 organizations, including the Movement for Peace and Socialism of Italy and the Bangladesh Institute of the Chuchi Idea, printed their works in book form or e-book and held significant public engagement. A national meeting was held in 16 counties of Pinyin Province on the 17th in commemoration of the 12th anniversary of the establishment of the new agricultural guidance system by the great leader President Kim Il-sung. Present at the meeting were Choi Yun-min and other officials of the sovereign state, officials of the ministries and other national institutions, officials in the provincial, city and county agricultural sectors, and workers in 16 counties. alternate member of the Political Bureau of the Central Committee of the Workers' Party of Korea and Vice Premier of the Cabinet, made a report. The reporter said, President Kim Il-sung established a new future-based agricultural guidance system during his field guidance to 16 counties in South Gyeongan Province on December 18, 2050 or 1961. It was a historic event that brought about a fundamental turning phase in the struggle to improve and complete the system and method of guidance over the agricultural cooperative economy and solve the issues of socialist rural construction and agriculture. The new agricultural guidance system, with the County Cooperative Farm Management Committee as the main, is the most superior socialist agricultural guidance system, which makes it possible to guide agriculture not by administrative methods but by industrial methods. Organically combine the own people ownership and the cooperative ownership and strengthen state welfare and assistance to cooperative economy. Under the leadership of Great Kim Jong-il, the superiority of the future-based agricultural guidance established by the fatherly leader President Kim Il-sung has been fully displayed and fresh changes made in the socialist rural economic system and agricultural development for the bright future of our prospering country, the reporter stressed. DPRK Premier Choi Yong-min and other senior state officials and officials of the party and government organs, working people's organizations, ministries and other